Okay, everyone, now let's actually go back inside this main activity.java file here. And now we want to actually put some lines of code here, okay? Okay, now I want to actually output the value that is inside of the index 5 of this array. So this is the index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3, index 4, and this is index 5, okay? So now here I can just put in this line of code here. So as you can see here, txt original array element dot set text string array sub index 5. Okay, so this piece of code here is going to actually give me the value that is inside of the index 5 of this string array here, as you can see. So now let's actually run our project. Okay, now as you can see here, our application is running on this emulator. So here, if I actually scroll down the screen here, we can see this value here, okay, f. The letter f, okay? Original array element value is $f, okay? So here, because we actually modified the array, the values that are actually inside of the array here in line 40, as you can see here, we actually called this let's modify the array method here. So because we modified the values that are actually inside of this array, now the letter f is actually preceded by actually a $ here, okay? So now let's actually go back inside this main activity.java file here. And here, I want to actually manipulate a specific element that is actually inside of this array element, okay? So let's actually create a method for that job, okay? So again, the access modifier of our method is public. The return type of our method is void. So this means that our method is going to actually return nothing, okay? And the name of our method is let's modify element, okay? And here inside of the parentheses, I need to actually specify an argument for this method. So the data type of our argument is string, okay? And the name of our argument is element, okay? And then I need to actually open and close this method by using these curly braces. And inside of this method, I want to actually manipulate this element value. So I just need to refer to the name of this element argument, okay, assignment operator, and here inside the double quotes I can just type in @ hashtag, okay, plus element, okay? So as you can see here, I actually put this value here inside of these double quotes here before this element here, okay, before this element argument. And now I can actually output this value, the element value, to the screen, okay? So I can just type in txt. So as you can see here, I want to refer to one of these objects here, as you can see, to txt modified array element, okay? And as you can see here, inside of this let's modify element, I cannot refer to this object, okay? Because this object, this text view, is actually created inside of this onCreate method, okay? And we cannot actually refer to a variable, to an object that is actually created in another method. So here I can just declare this object. So I can just copy this text view txt modify array element here, and then I can just put it inside of this class, and then I need to put in a semicolon here, okay? And then I can just delete this text view here, okay? In this way, we declared this text view inside of this class. And here, inside of this onCreate method, we are actually instantiating this object, okay? txt modify array element. And now, inside of this let's modify element, I can actually refer to that object, as you can see here, txt modify array element. So let's actually test and see what happens. Let's modify array element. So I can refer to the name of that text view now, okay? Dot set text element. And now, let's actually call this method here. Let's modify element. So now I need to actually provide a value as an argument for this method, okay? So as you can see, the data type of my argument is string, okay? So I need to actually provide a value of type string. So here I can just refer to the name of the string array sub index 5, okay? So in this way, I can actually get this value, okay? The value that is inside of the index 5 of this array. So as you can see, this value f new line character, okay, And here I can just put it here. String array sub index 5. Okay, so let's actually run our project and see what happens. So now as you can see, our application is actually running on this emulator. And here, if I actually scroll down the screen here, I want to actually see this value here, modified array element @ hashtag $f. Okay, so now I want to actually output the value of array element after modification. Okay, so after the modified array element, as you can see, this array is now, for example, modified. Okay, so now again, I want to output the original value that is inside of the index 5 of this array. Okay, string array. So let's see what happens. And here, after this line of code here, so just type in here txt array element after modification, okay, dot set text string array sub index 5. And now let's actually run our project and see what happens. So now our application is actually running on this emulator. And now if I actually scroll down the screen here, let's see what happens. So as you can see here, value of array element after modification is $f. Okay, so the most important point I want you to actually know is that whenever we actually modify the values that are actually inside of an array, as we did in line 42, let's modify the array here, elements that are actually inside of that array are going to be modified, okay, forever. Okay, because when we actually create an array, we are actually creating a reference to some objects, to some value inside of the memory, okay? And when we modify that array, the values that are actually inside of that array are going to be modified too, okay? But when we actually modify a specific element that is actually inside of an array, as we did here, okay? Let's modify element, okay? Only a copy of that modified element is going to be created, okay? And then that value, as you can see on this emulator here, this is that value @ hashtag $f, okay? But the original value is not changed, okay? Because we only modified a specific element that is actually inside of that array, okay? And as you can see here, value of array element after modification is $f. So whenever we actually create an array, we are actually creating a reference to that array. So that's why the values that are actually inside of this array are actually modified, okay? So hopefully that makes sense. And I think that's enough for this tutorial. And if you have any questions, please post the discussion in the course and I'll do my best to answer your questions. And thank you very much for watching and I'll see you in the next tutorial.